planets have had a very interesting impact on human beings for thousands of years at least. There have been people who have studied them as scientific objects. There have been others who have revered them and worshipped them as spiritual or devotional field. Muthuswamy Dikshitar belonged to the latter category. He composed at least on the 7 weekday songs, the Vara Krithis. A few people also think that he composed on Rahu and Ketu, so they actually call that as a Navagraha Krithi set. But there is a bit of debate about the Krithi in Rama Manohari, which is Smaramyaham Sada Rahum, as well as the one in Chamaram, Mahasuram Ketumaham, which is why some other scholars believed that it was just the Vara Krithis that were originally Dikshitars and the other two were later on added by somebody else. So this course I will focus on the Vara Krithis. I actually know the other two also. I used to render the whole thing as Navagraha Krithi set only. But for now, since there is a bit of cloud over those planets which cause eclipse themselves, I'll now focus only on the Vara Krithi. Surya Murte Namostute in Saurashtra has been set to Chaturashtra Jati Dhruva Talam. Very interestingly, Dikshitar used the Sapta Talas for the Vara Krithis. Chandram Bhajamanasa will be in Chaturashtra Jati Matte Talam. Angarakam Ashrayamyaham in Chaturashtra Jati Rupaka Talam. Buddham Ashrayamyaham in Mishra Jati Jhampa Talam. Brihaspate Tarapate in Tishra Jati Triputa Talam. Shri Shukra Bhagavantam in Khandajati Atatalam. Divakara Tanujam in Chaturashtra Jati Ekatalam. So like this, Dikshitar was a master planner, a master designer. If he had been in military, he would probably have been a commander-in-chief or something. He was a big strategist. He could come up with a lot of themes and create artistic patterns within that. Now, the other important aspect of this is in world music, there was this other Western classical composer called Gustav Holst, who was a British composer. He actually composed a piece, an orchestral, Western orchestral piece called The Planets. Now, it's of course very speculative for us to say that he was inspired by Dikshitar or not, because there is no direct evidence of that. But certain things which are interesting to observe are that he lived almost 100 years after Dikshitar. So Dikshitar was from 1770s, but Holst was from 1870s. And Holst also happened to be interested in Rigvedas, Mahabharata. He composed some of the other works based on Ramayana, Mahabharata and other things. So there could be, since he was also a Sanskrit scholar, he might have come across some of these things, but this is still speculative. So I'm only mentioning this as a passing reference at this stage. More research has to be done to establish such things. But it's interesting to study these things because we can see how Carnatic music has influenced so many other genres of music. Even today it continues to do so. Today you see so many jazz artists or pop artists or even Western classical artists and others collaborating with artists from Carnatic. And similarly, Carnatic music itself was influenced because Dikshitar himself was influenced by Western classical orchestras in his times. He also composed some of the English notes within Sanskrit lyrics, but trying to follow some of the established Western classical tunes of his times. So music has had a very interesting interplay across cultures. And so it's interesting for all of us to be aware of all these things and take pride in the fact that this is one of the brilliant systems of music in the world, which has had and continues to have a global impact.